something on an Arduino board. Oh, amazing. Even you ask a person of age 60 what you're doing. I'm trying to make this group to make my all friends to become to know when my second vaccination jab is going to be there and how they can open the app to be get registered themselves. Creations. Entrepreneurs means you are connecting with the society. You are serving to the society, of course, with your own talents, your own skills, and the skills which has been acquired during your degree, during your graduation, and of course, with through your mentors. This is what today we are going to be discussing here. So I've just take up to this. Who's an entrepreneur first? If you are from the branch of electronics and communication, you are from the field of photonics or maybe optical, whatever you are, you have to take some risk. What is that? I'll tell you, risk is very simple. Ma'am, I want to pursue this thesis. Okay, beta, you can. Ma'am, this is my problem formulation. Wonderful. You do the literature survey. They start doing the literature survey. After doing a literature review, they publish one paper, maybe on the comparative analysis or something. After 1 year, even you will come to know that it is a reinventing of wheel. Somebody already have designed in maybe in Japan or maybe in Korea. So my this program, my this particular thesis, my this topic may not get be in a patentable position or may not the thesis is going to be get in the. So immediately you take a turn. You may add something in it. You may tweak out something in it. This is what the entrepreneurs do. Risk taking when you are going to operate something. What is the successful features? You know, you have to drive it out. What to drive it out? I spoken to many guys today. They speak something, you know, amazing things about apps, about software designing, and of course some hardware part also. Until unless some force is going to drive them to the next level, these ideas die down. In my country and in this universe, we speak out the success rate of the startups. What is the success rate of the startups? 5%. Similarly, I had one good discussions, you and Novan. I brought my SWAM there and I discussed about the SWAM portal there in 38 countries, secretaries in Geneva. So they said MOOCs also have the success rate of 3%. Means 100 do get registered and 3 only do the certification at the final stage. That's what the MIT edX claim and of course the many more agencies. I asked one question. If SWAM could make a success rate of 80%, similarly, Indian startups can make a success rate of 80% until unless we do give a driving force. Yes, mentoring. Mentoring is most important. Thinking ability that encompasses. I'll tell you, I can't change your mind. You can't change my mind. I have my own thought process. You have your own thought process. But I can do one thing. I can map up. I can adopt, I can move together with common minimum thought process. End of the day, who's listening me? They may agree with me. Education is one of the biggest tool to be get the human development. I think it's a common. Second, you must be agree with me. We must do something for our country like India. Yes, again it's matching. Third thing, I must contribute back to my society what society have given me till date. Maybe in the form of teachers, maybe in the form of parents, maybe in the form of relatives, maybe in the form of, you know, our stakeholders, etc. These are the matching things. We have to just look at the matching things together and then we'll go for the analytical abilities and originality. Aptitude for the human relations is the most important. I want to touch one thing over here. At least in this pandemic situation, we learned a lot many lessons. Out of this, I tell you one lesson. What is that one lesson to all parents, to all my school teachers? What is that lesson? Just listen very carefully. Why muted your mics? Even all organizers have to keep muted their mic because this line, this topic which I'm touching is a very, very significant. You know, from the school level itself, from admission till BTech or even up to BTech, we were very much emphasizing on an IQ level. Yes, it was the most thrust area for all parents. My son should crack this exam, should qualify this quiz. I think somebody's mic is on. I request, please, if you can mute your mics, please, all the organizers even, just for 40 minutes. After that, you can unmute yourself, no issue. So, you know, IQ we emphasize a lot, and it is need of hour. Yes, we have to be a global citizen. But same times, it creates an imbalancing. If you put a more sugar in a 2 cup of tea and keeping the milk quantity less, or maybe even a tea powder less, do you think it is a good tea? No, you say it's not a tea. It's a just a sweetened water you are serving me. Same thing happened to this. Because IQ becomes so good, so high, our SQ, our EQ got diminished, reduced, and that's what in the hospitals, even some of the poor EQ people, maybe the healthcare people, they do created some nuisance, like by removing the cylinder from one patient to give it to another patient to whom they got some bribe. Even some people selling the empty bottles, filling up water inside and saying it is a vaccination or it is a life-saving drugs, etc. And some ambulance drivers charging. IQ is there. He knows I am a driver. I can drive ambulance. That is IQ. That is the, you know, intelligence. And he applied IQ to be charged hefty charges of ambulance for 2 kilometers, 1 lakh rupees. 7 kilometers, 1 lakh rupees. What is that? EQ got diminished. No emotions, no spirituality. They don't understand. End of the day, we are the brothers, sisters of same God, the same father and mother. So that's the one thing. So aptitude for the human relations, the communication skills. This is again one of the tools for the entrepreneurs they must have. And of course, technical ability, which you are going to be improve yourself. Today, I am discussing with the teachers, and teachers must be wondering, sir, why you are teaching all these kind of lessons to us? We are the already teachers, sir. We already have done PhD. We are M.Tech. We are great scholars. We published so many papers in SCA journals. We have done our great thesis. Dear respected teachers, you all are great. I do salute. I do always give respect. But it is a time, if I want to change my country's thought process, my country's level to be making to the next level, I have to first go for the teachers. Because teacher is only the national builder. The teacher is only. End of the day, to you today, ask any great sportsman or a politician or an economist or even engineer or even a doctor, they have been come out from the teacher's hand first. Then only they become the successful in their area and region. So end of the day, teachers, the parenting and teaching is the most important tools. That's why I'm touching you. So recognizes, you have to teach your guys, you know. So teaching 60 students, rather I am today, if teaching 60 teachers, I think I am teaching more than 6 lakh students, because you are going to touch your world. One teacher and in one life, more or less, if you are teaching physically, 40,000 students you are touching. But if you are coming through MOOCs platforms, I think you may touch around 6 lakh students in your lifespan, or even more than that, if you become a good celebrity. Yes, my today teacher should be an academic celebrity. How do you recognize opportunities? Being a teacher, I think I recognize many opportunities, and you too also. Many of the faculty members, they identified different types of techniques, how to teach the students through this camera, through this laptop. You created a Google Classroom, then you are asking your students to go on a Jamboard, and going on a Jamboard, you are giving a quizzes assignments and they are unable to even copy down, you know. So online proctor examination is entirely different than what the teachers do conduct. So how to make the entrepreneurs in a business domain means to be get some revenue generated. If my today faculty is not going to become an entrepreneur, educational entrepreneur, I doubt my universities will sustain for after one decade. Government of India is not giving any fund more to the state universities. This is HEFA. Higher Education Funding Agency, you are taking loan. Private universities already invested a lot in their infrastructure, classrooms, laboratories. Now you are asking them to be put more fund for the cloud storage. You are asking more funds to be creating some studios and developing some e-contents, LMS systems. End of the day, how much they will spend? They have to spend for some limits. Until unless the faculty will bring the consultancy, the faculty will become the research proposal, the faculty will become a MOOCs creator, designer, or a digital teacher, I think universities will not going to be make you to survive. You have to look into some other job. I am sorry to say, but this is what happening in the other countries, and this is what it should be happen in my country, India. Every faculty should know how I can be a sellable before the society. You know, many teachers, they do attract because of the teacher's branding, admissions happens. With the teacher's branding, admission happens. Oh, this sir is teaching in this college. Mama, I want to take admission over there because he is the sir. Once he teach someone, definitely he is going to join Google or maybe a Facebook or something. This is the personal branding. Because of your branding, you may attract admissions. Of course, college legacy will be there. Your logo branding will be there. Your group branding will be there. That is because of the trust. That is because of the management. That is because of the, you know, past percentage students or your, of course, alumnus based on this. But how the teachers are going to be drive it out, that is another thing. So opportunity recognitions, the window for the opportunities, it is a situational. You must be wondering, sir, why you're talking these kind of words? Okay, listen carefully. You are in Bangalore, the faculty members from Bangalore or maybe the nearby region. You know, you have a huge opportunity now to be get improve your admissions in your campus. Sir, how it can be possible? Listen to me. 37% of the Indian students, those supposed to be travel this year abroad for their admissions, like in Australia, Canada, UK, US, they dropped their idea because of COVID. No flights, they can't. But many international universities are in call with the Indian universities. You take admission there only. We are going to teach in a blended mode. And 1 year let them spend, or maybe the couple of years let us spend in your campus, because your campus has the equal, you know, ambience, of course, resources, laboratories, and of course, faculty. We will take them in the third year and we will honor all the credits under ABC, that is Academic Bank of Credits. Yes, this is called internationalization of campus. Do the faculty do write some emails to the foreign universities to be get collaborate? This is what the opportunity is called, a opportunity as a situational. Opportunities take from the real world conditions. What is that? Leads and lags, knowledge gaps. So you do already. You do this kind of entrepreneurship. Dear student, you want to go for the mechanical, come to our campus. We have the huge mechanical lab, because many mechanical professors brought the great equipments under their PhD program, under their research proposals from DST or maybe from AICT, from UGC, etc. What is that? Opportunities take from the real world conditions. This is what I'm totally linking with your teaching profession. Don't worry, but I'm teaching entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship is the tool which everybody should know. You know, you go to on the road, on the lights, where traffic lights, you will find one of the great entrepreneur over there. You say, sir, what you are talking? Yes, I observed many beggars. They have never done BTech. They never done MBA, but they know when the red light comes, by looking my face from the shield, window shield, they come to know that whether this guy is going to put a glass down and putting something coin in my bowl or not. They go exactly to that particular person, especially to that particular lady, which may be a bit mature, must be a mother. Then she will definitely say, oh, 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 bacha hai godi mein, so I must give something to him. Oh, he is a lachar, he is something. Because they understand, they read our EQ. They understand our emotional quotient. They are the entrepreneurs. End of the day, they are doing their business for their stomach. They have to get some coins, and evening they have to have their dosa or idli. This is what entrepreneurship starts from, the beggars till Ambani. Even Ambani knows what should be the entrepreneurship. Again, mic unmuted by someone. I have to request organizers to mute. Thank you, because noise always disturbs the audience and me, because we are in connection. We are thinking, we are putting our own mind what basically we are discussing. Product or service is still not in existence. Are you looking something? Yes, look at here. Just after the COVID, how many apps came up? Earlier it was Zoom, Sky Call, we used to know. How sudden this blue jeans, how sudden this Namaste India, how sudden this so many, go to meeting, go to webinar and Google suit, etc. has come up because of this war not existing. And today is a big crowd teaching country like India, where you have more than 30 crores of learners, more than 30 crores of learners. Do you think one app will be sufficient to be given this load? Not at all. You also changed from Google Suite to the MS Teams today, and many of the teachers still learning how to use. This is what product or service is already in the market, but failed to satisfy the customers. What happened with the Zoom? 40 minutes call after disconnect. What happened to the Zoom? 100 participants, beyond 100 participants, you have to buy the license. That's why the Google just jump in it for 250 participants free of cost with a Google suit, etc., blah, blah. These are the situational factors which do give you a boom. Till before pandemic, you go to any market, you can buy kerchiefs, you can buy, ladies used to buy the, you know, hair head and many this kind of accessories matching to their suits. Today, I think in my city, more than 100 shops selling masks matching to your suits, different colors, embroidery. I've been to just in Lucknow last to last month at the, there is one, you know, brand, Ada, ADA. I could see the great silky masks with great embroidery and worth of 500 rupees of one piece, although it's a mask only. It's not 1095, but it's a fashionable mask. This is called the product or service not in existence, and you jump in it and you can start selling in it. I still remember a Kerala guy last year when this corona came. He was a photocopier. He started creating a mask with your photograph. And when you are wearing a mask, it looks like you are not wearing a mask because the same picture, what exactly your face, that area is going to be covered with the mask. He's just creating in a 15 minutes of time. It's not charging more than 200 rupees. This is what, you know, innovation. It's an innovative idea. One photocopier machine guy becomes, I think, millionaire, if I'm not billionaire, but millionaire. I could see in the newspaper itself, this is got. I just look into this Ola people and Uber rooms, etc. They have no property like a Tata or, you know, the big hotels. They don't have even a single room on their credit. But today they are fetching the customers more than a Oberoi Group and Tata Group in throughout the world through Oyo rooms. And same with the Ola. He doesn't have his own Maruti 800 even, I believe. But he's booking your Mazdis also through his app. This is what the entrepreneur. So opportunities identification, approach to opportunity identification. So dear participants, dear faculty members, you have to tell your students, observe change in the environment. Changing in the environment. I still remember, have you seen the movie of Rajkumar? That movie in which he's asking to be, Nutan to become under the umbrella. Itna pyara song hai. Can you find the similar umbrella as on today? That big shark knob and the black color umbrella having so many strings. Now it's an electronic umbrella with LED letter. So this LED light is falling on the bottom that you should see the even road. So all umbrellas, which I bought it from Thailand sometimes 6 years back when I was there in AIT, I could find it. I'm fascinated. Oh, when I open the umbrella, the LED light glows and automatically falling on the bottom because this is a new innovation. And that umbrella itself by droplets, sensors, umbrella get change its shape. If it is a windy, it gets shaped like this. It should not fly off because holding the umbrella itself sometimes a difficulty with the ladies when they are walking on a road and the big wind blows. Just giving one example for umbrella. There are so many examples around your surroundings. Have you ever bothered? Umbrella got manufactured 100 years back also. Umbrella is still manufacturing today, but what is that name umbrella? But see the innovations, see the design structures, see the new facilities, umbrella with the LEDs, amazing. That's the thing. So recognize a need that customers have that is not being satisfied. Recognize problems and find ways to solve it. Having umbrella in hand, but at bottom, you do not know where there is a water and your all clothes are going to be get wetted. Why not to have one LED and it's internally one tablet cell, which will long lasting. That's what. Economic forces, social forces, technological advancements, and of course, political and regulatory statutes. Now, you know, we have make it permanent that without mask, you can't go out on your scooter and car. So can't we give this kind of a sensor on your car looking to your face? Because many of the cars have their sensors. Instead of say, fix your seat belt. One more beep will come. Put your mask. Until unless you will not put your mask on a face, the vehicle is not going to be start. Your Activa is not going to get start. This is what You do it. It is a very simple, small sensor camera. Look into this level. If it is not covered, I think already student have created this app. When you're entering somebody, the door is not going to be get open. And it's a facial recognition camera. So face, when your half face is not covered with some, you know, mask sort of stuff or texture, no opening of lock. So ignition is not going to be start. Your car is not going to be start. This is what technological advantage, social forces and economic. I can't spend, either way, I will be keep speaking. One day is even less to be talk on this topic. Entrepreneurship cannot be teach by book. It cannot be teach by any your PG or UG program. I'm sorry to say, it is inherency. If you are zero to understand, you will listen to someone, you will watch a holding, you will read the newspaper, you will watch the TV, you will watch a people in your surrounding, you will have an idea and you will become an entrepreneur. I can give you the 100 and 1,000 examples, though are not even a matriculate, but they are the very successful people today, the great businessmen, because one Jugaad technology. It's India's one of the best tool, Jugaad technology. They brought it to the lab and lab could become a patent, and once this patent is going to be get designed, That's it. Company is behind you. Ability to search and discover a business opportunity. It is not to be you have to go for some Himalaya to search some business opportunity. It is not even required to go to some mall to be search and go to Japan to be search some. It is there in your home, on your chair when you're sitting. I'll give you a very simple example here. I think you people are nowadays listening. Every government says all the public transport will ply with the 50% of capacity. Have you ever counted the passengers sitting in the bus? Are they 50% only? Never ever possible. Do you think it's possible? Not at all. Some bus will be even a 25% occupancy, and some bus will be even full packed, because who's going to check? And we don't have that level of, you know, surveillance by checking every bus is flying with the 50% facility. Even malls, they said 50%. Anyhow, I'll give you one example. Every bus have that display outside. Every bus have the standard seats inside, that is 52 seats. Every bus seats can have a small one weight sensor. The each and every person who's traveling in a bus, average weight is 40 to say 70 kg, average, or even 50 to 70 kg per pax, per passenger, average. If we put a sensors, a weight sensors, the outside bus only, the passenger will come to know how many seats are available in the bus. Many times in a local bus, people climb the bus, they stand in the doors. Many seats are vacant. Looking from outside, the lady says, no, it's crowded bus. I'll go to the next bus. Later, when the bus will close, oh, many seats are empty. I could not climb this bus, because this sometimes, you know, youngsters, I shouldn't say, but they stand in the doors only because they have to get down the next stop, but they don't sit. So they don't give a passage to them. But if the outside bus only the LEDs glows, these many green lights means these many seats available. These many red lights means people occupied. I think it's a great. So people come to know, oh, 5 seats are available. Why should not I climb and I get my seat? Because 5 seats are vacant. Green light is glowing outside. And this is simple LED and one sensors. It's a one-time investment. These are small. There are thousands of examples. We can, I think if I'm speaking, you can do the 10 patents designs today itself. You are listening to me. So the customers, the retailers, the business associates, and of course bankers, these are the mechanism to identify the opportunities. You go to the banker. You say, sir, simply, sir, I want a loan. For what, man? Where is your DPR, detailed project? Sir, I don't have detailed project report, but I want to do something. Sometimes banker will say, look, gentlemen, I have a 3 reports. They came up, but they could not become the grantor. They could not bring the other documents. You take this address, meet that guy. You both come together. You have this much caution money. He has an idea. You join the hands together. Sometimes bankers helping you. Sometimes business associates helping you. Sometimes retailers. I'm asking you, I want to buy this thing, but you are not giving to me. So can't you discover for me? Look it for the masks. When the masks came in the market, all masks are with the, you know, connecting with the ears, but we are the turban guy. How to wear my mask? There was no mask for me to be have the strips. Then I wrote, I made many people to be create this kind of mask. Then a local tailor, I asked the local tailor, and he was so busy, he given me mask after 1 week. Sir, I have a huge order for all the 6 gentlemen. They are asking for this mask. And later on, the company copied down, now even N95 having that kind of mask, which I can wear above the turban. Just see, otherwise all masks are the same, because I can't wear that mask because I used to be put a turban. Have you ever thought of it? Because it's my problem. I'm a customer. So I given my problem to the society and somebody has created an idea and he designed the mask and he becomes an entrepreneur. That's it. Experience and exposure, knowledge and skills, and of course, special alertness. Special alertness. If you are a conscious mind, I think you are an entrepreneur. Any conscious mind on this earth while traveling, while sleeping, while eating, while drinking, while reading, while writing, can observe something which can be innovate, which can be a society solution, application. That's it. So evaluation and selection process is B part. What is the searching for ideas? Search for the product or service for the idea. These are the classifications. This is the standard tree. You have to follow this. Anyhow, I'm not going to teach in that details, but I'm just going to be discussing the live manner. What exactly in our life, what we are going to face and how we are going to be achieved. So these are your, you know, magazines and other publications, trade shows, product licensing information, government agencies, use creative thinking, etc. These comes under this. What are the major aspects for the entrepreneurship here? I'm talking identification of market opportunity. You talk about the photonics. You talk about the fiber optics. You know, now, because of you people, the photonics society, I must give this credit to you people. Because of you, we are making reach of sunlight from the far distance place to the place where sun can never reach. Yes, through fiber optics. With the fiber optics, they are capturing a sunlight from here and sending to the other end without loss of signals in between. And this is what's happening in many countries, in many regions, there is a black. Black, what is that? Because the sun never comes that way because of mountaineering area, the geographical conditions, trains. In our Arunachal Pradesh, many particular mountains, they give a complete shadow and that houses are never going to get sterilized because of sunlight is not falling over there. Okay. Is there any message for me? Is somebody unmuted or shall I continue? Okay, so gathering and commitment of resources in the face of risk to pursue the opportunity. That is a major aspect of entrepreneurship. So gathering and commitment. Commitment of resources. You want to save water? See, you brought sensor taps, putting a hand under, then only the, you want to save, you know, many other things, but still, have you ever bothered to be save oxygen? Which is there in this environment. Now we are realizing about the value of oxygen at least, because when we bought oxygen these days, then we realized that God given a thousands or billions of cylinders free of cost to us, not charging a single penny, but we are not taking care of the oxygen concentrator given by a God. We are very much worried about the one cylinder to be kept in house and bought for worth of thousands of rupees. And that's what the opportunity do makes you to be understand this. The creation of an operating business organization to implement the opportunity, motivated business idea. Until unless your idea is motivated, which gives you self-motivation, then the motivation to your financier, motivation to your partner, motivation to your designer or implementer. I think this idea is not going to be a worth. So this creation of an operating business does mean the motivation comes from your idea itself. This is what, you know, in the structure of the population and income, the yes, teenagers, they go cyber cafes, Cineplex and the recording studios, the passenger cars, household furniture, DVDs, people have a higher purchasing power. These are examples how changes the environment provides the opening for the new products and services. Have you ever thought 20 years back the multiplex? One cinema hall was there in one city. I'm talking some 30 years, 40 years back. Today in one particular mall, you have the five cinema halls. You want to watch this movie, go there. You want to watch this movie, you go there. Even English movies going there, Kannada movies going on, even a Hindi movies going on. I still remember I went to the Bangalore Galaxy sometimes and I was amazed to know, two cinemas back to back means I can watch Kannada movie as well as Hindi movie same day. Otherwise, we have to take auto and go to some other place. Technological advances, the advances in biotechnology, development of the internet, So it is you to choose what exactly and how to move it and how to motivate your students to move further, whether it's an e-commerce or biotechnology or maybe a photonics society or maybe in the food chain, etc. Just look at here. In this COVID situation, the Zomato and Swiggy, they have jumped to the, I think, double to triple profit. Reason is because the home delivery was live. All the restaurants got connected. Even the ready person who's putting street foods could survive because he was cooking at home and Zomato guy was picking and dropping to my house. Same dosa, same idli, but it could reach to me. And particularly when person is in a quarantine state and he's alone in no family members to look after, he could survive because of this tiffins and dabba walas of Mumbai, because they could produce the food and put on their doorstep and taking this food. Think of it. Although it's an innovation, although it's an entrepreneurship, but we could save so many lives, at least during this period and maybe in future also. How to select the right opportunities, again, one, you know, question, and you should keep in mind identification of the, you know, of course it is your personal goal, how much you want to earn in your life, how much you want to travel in your life, how much far you can go from your family, are you looking for the family piece first and then you are looking your business consignments and assignments, etc. Research and favorite industries you are interested in, maybe in a footwears, or you may be interested in a maybe an R&D of science technology. Then it is some, you want some industry to be set up or you want small startup, that's it. So it is all identify the problem areas and brainstorming is what required for the solutions. Compare possible solutions with your objectives. You have many ideas, but you have to choose one to be moved further. Otherwise, if you'll go in a many ideas, you will be lose somewhere. Characteristics of an ideal business. Do you find ideal business? No ideal business. Business cannot, even teacher can't be ideal. Even a government can't be ideal, how the business can be ideal. But still, you see, which business you find no investment? So it is possible. Has a recognized measurable market? No way. How I can measure my market? Sometimes I am underestimated, sometimes I overestimated. Require no labor force? Not at all possible. Without labor, either it's a IT labor, either it's a human labor, either it's a manufacturing labor, you need a labor. And of course, buyers. Buyers are very much needed. Characteristics for the ideal business. These are the characteristics like publicity value, customer pay in advance, no risk of product liability. So dear friends, if you are looking for the ideas, so there will be a turbulence. And turbulence is the big bone of business. If there is a turbulency, then only you can book your profit. If it is a turbulency, you can take more risk. If it is a turbulency, then only you can grab more opportunities. So turbulency is the one, I can say, the thumb rule for the business. Turbulence will be there. Streamlined business can't be a business. It can be NGO. It's a non-profitable thing. That is a streamline. So business must have the turbulence. Look at the big people. Those are worth of billionaires. They also becomes a bankrupts also. And look at some guy who never have a single penny in his account. And today he's a, you know, the owner of many properties, something like that. So it's a recognized needs and wants, the find the solutions. These are the some ways. I have to move a little further because I have time limit, which I have to be compete. Can make money and has the potential for growth. These are the criteria for this evaluation. Less competition. Good fit between entrepreneurs and opportunity. This is the most important part. Has competitive advantage. Don't think I'm alone in the city and I can sell a lot. No. If you have the similar competitive guys, I think you can sell better. You see, go to any market, you say, oh, it's a books market. Oh, sir, in this market, all shops are hardware shops. At childhood, I used to wonder, Papa, if already there is a one shop, why these 10 shops are there? End of the day, we are going to buy a tap. We can buy a tap from this particular Goel senators. Why that Gupta senators are there and others, I could not understand. Now I could understand. When there is a market, the customer knows my needs are going to be fulfilled. And he's coming with the final mind, I am going to buy. And end of the day, it's a market people who is going to give some promotions, quality, assurance, of course, soft skills. And of course, sometimes credit. definitely they are going to be a big seller, but others will also survive, because end of the day, many customers will come looking to the crowd in the one shop, and they must be in sometimes in hurry. They will definitely go to the other shop, and later on the other shop guy is also going to improve the quality. I could see, you go to any city, there is a specific market for, you know, cloth market, hardware market, books market, etc. Why market? Because all shops of the same category of products, and that makes sense, and that's why they are going to be, and they prefer to be get the shop there only, although there is a competition, there are so many like you, but still not against the norms and values of the community. You should not go beyond this, conform with laws and of course regulations given by state government, local administration, and of course government of India. These are the criterias. So this is entrepreneurial process. A buy a business, or maybe start a new business, or acquire a franchisee. Anything can be happen. Anything can be taken. All having an equal advantage. And of course, there must be some limitation of your growth. If it is a franchisee, you have a bound with certain norms by the master franchisor. And if it is a start new business, you may have little bit risk factor more, whether your product is going to be get launched in a true spirit. And of course, when you are going to buy a business, you, can you maintain the legacy which he has maintained? Can you maintain the quality or the same customer bank which he has given to you in the shape of royalty he charged from you by selling you the old business? We call it called, are uska jama jamaya business khareed lo. So, you know, you can buy someone's business, but you can't buy somebody's destiny. So buying a destiny is not possible. Buying a business is possible. So better you have your idea. And of course, you can put your idea in the same existing business. Then it makes a sense. Then it makes really sense. So that's another way. What is your entrepreneurial potential? You have to look at yourself. You have to evaluate your managerial skills. You have to understand the demands of the entrepreneurial role. Of course, you have to conduct your personal assessment. What is that? Do you have the bank balance? Do you have the good CIBIL score that bank can lend you money? If you do not have a CIBIL, you are a defaulter with your credit card, you're a defaulter with the EMI. Don't you think that they are going to give you a current account and they will give you some limits? No way. So you should have a good repo in the market. The people can trust you. They can fund you. They can lend you money, even borrowers. So this is the different potentials you have to look at in yourself before you are going to become an entrepreneur. This is matters a lot sometimes. So there are certain market issues, like to whom you are going to sell, whether it's available here in this. Suppose if I'm going to be open Alu Parotha shop, of course, in Bangalore. Alu Parotha, tumba chanagidu, nam gotayitu. How many people will enjoy the Alu Parotha other than dosa? That's again a question. But sometimes now it's a variety, you know. In Delhi, there are two shops simultaneously near to Janpath. And there's a big, big queue for the, you know, Madhur Vada. Madhur Vada gotayitu, na? Madhur Vada and Masala Vada, there is a big rush, but Bhatura Chana, less rush, because the North people now enjoy the South food more. So opening a South dish like, you know, Sagar Ratna or these kind of chains popular in Delhi and North as compared to your South, because in South you will get same taste at home also. But we will not get the same taste at home because we don't have that the recipe or maybe that spices which to be required. So how do you promote your sales? How do you price your output? What do customers expect? These are the market issues, then certain financial issues. Okay, I'll quickly moving further. These financial issues are very typical. And generally we say this, if finance is not proper, we may die down in between. The entrepreneurs, and I think most of the entrepreneurs' success stories goes to the bad stories because of their funding delinking. So they should have the proper funding arrangement and at least a visionary documentation to go for the leasing for the long and for venture capitals. And of course, you have to put so many employees, how to cost cutting, how to go for the conservation of your energy as well as your budget. So that matters a lot. And this is what is required for the entrepreneurs to be keep in mind, because without fuel, no vehicle can run. So without fund, no business can run. Yes, it can run. If one financier will come and take your idea, then you can go simultaneously. That is the only way. Otherwise, you have to arrange the funds. So these are the successful entrepreneurs, you know, advantages which you are going to be achieve. You are a boss of yourself. You don't have to see the watch at what time you have to open and close your office. Enjoy the profits, whatever you are earning. You go for a world tour, you take your family here and there. Sense of pride sometimes. So I'm a successful man. I'm a successful entrepreneur. Of course, I'm giving more than 1,000 people's employment in this world. This is a great, you know, it's a pride. You are doing charity sort of things. Flexibility in your work schedule, etc. You were given a work from home to many of your employees. At least they are safe. They give you the hidden blessings, and blessings works a lot. Now I'll show you something more. What are the different areas? So ask your students, are they going to become a job seeker or job creator? I think they should prefer job creators. And they must be asking, sir, what kind of jobs? Give them the list. You want to be a self-entrepreneur? You want to be a digital entrepreneur, agro-entrepreneur, educational entrepreneur, social media entrepreneur, environment entrepreneur, healthcare entrepreneur. In one particular topic, I need minimum 2 hours to explain. In self-entrepreneur, what are the opportunities? I can speak 2 hours continuously. For the digital entrepreneurs, a huge discussion can take place. So all are the threads, all are the openings. I'm giving one shot. There are many more slides can be shown. And they will ask, sir, how it can be possible? They must ask, then show this slide. Then show this slide. Dear students, look at to the left-hand side. They know these people. Oh, Dhirubhai Ambani. Yes, I know, sir. Ratan Tata. Sir, you don't know. I know Ratan Tata. Ah, Azim Bhaiji. Narayana Murthy. Oh, Vikshri. Ananda Mahendra. Shivnadar. They will be agree with you. These are the top 10 entrepreneurs of their time. Ask them to read these said names. Ritesh Agarwal, Indrajit Singh, Dipanjali, Dalmia, Ranveer Alabadia, and this. Sir, who's this? Then ask them, Google out. And then show them individually one by one. Look at guys, Akshay Ruparelia, an Indian who became one of the youngest millionaires in the UK. He started doorstep.uk, an online estate agency with 12 employees, with the company has managed to achieve £12 million valuation within a year. Kavita Shukla, the founder of Fresh Paper, she innovated an idea to keep the numerous products fresh for longer hours. Today you are getting a Subway wrap, you know, loaf. What that paper? It's a different paper. Her clients including big names like Whole Foods and cooperatives. Oh, Tilak Mehta, one of the youngest of the, these all are 25 years age when they become entrepreneurs. He has made the Ola and Uber for the Dabbawalas, you know, in Bombay. Dabbawalas, they have their own Ola and Ubers. His latest achievement, launching app for delivery called Paper and Parcel, Intercity. He's gained this great name. Okay, Trishneet Arora, a school dropout, not even clear metric. A huge success and a self-made man, Trishneet Arora's complete package, launching the company TAC Security Solutions with 4 offices in India and of course one in Dubai. I visited his office personally. That's why I know that clients with the Reliance, etc., they are taking business from him. Logistics support, you know. He's a metric dropout guy. Okay. Oh, Shri Lakshmi Suresh, an old website designer. She single-handed designed 50 websites in a year. Last year, her work includes being awarded the world's youngest web designer award and running her venture e-design. Anshuman Sinha, called the youngest talent manager at the age of 25, he runs the Represent as a multi-genre talent management company. Along that, he's campaigning hashtag Take India to the world. Just go to the hashtag. Has gained immense popularity, adding on to the reason due to which he won Young Business Leader Under 40 Award in 2018. Ranveer Alabadia, a man many talents, runs a YouTube channel as well as his own company. I'm giving example of each entrepreneurship. You could see educational entrepreneur. You could see multimedia entrepreneur. You could see environmental entrepreneur. Every entrepreneur successful, students, young guys, even a dropouts, I'm giving example. True, no fake. Go to Google, search these names. And if you find anything fake, I'm available. Dipanjali Dalemia, a brave soul who left her job. Ernest Young mein job milna apne aap mein bahut badi baat. She left the job in age of 26. Just see the, you know, how she was dared to do this. She started her own journey backed by social cause. Just see, social entrepreneur. To help women in the country, her venture, Heyday Care produces the sanitary pads made out of the bamboo fire and cone. It's effective and cheap one. That's it. Lower price available. Dipanjali, I salute you. Inderjit Singh, he's the founder CEO of the iQuanta. Have you ever seen the educational entrepreneur like Inderjit Singh? He's all guys cracking CAT exams. You know, he's having a wizard of Quantas. He's helped more than 8,000 students to get into IIMs and B schools in my India. Just Google out and see what he's the CEO of the iQuantas. Young guy, 25, 26 years, Ritesh Agarwal, a smart young man who used to be valuable insights gained while pursuing his hobby, traveling to a business idea, need for a budget traveling. You give your budget, he will give you the destination, he will give you the hotel names, he will give you the complete how many you have to pay for the cab, everything. Everything is going to be great. All you'll get OYA rooms. And he started this OYA rooms somewhere in 2013. Ritesh Agarwal, that's all my top 10 entrepreneurs from the social entrepreneurship, educational entrepreneurship, digital entrepreneurship, and of course, agro entrepreneurship as well. With this, I just wanted to conclude my talk. Well, in time given to me, you can connect me anytime through my, of course, Facebook, LinkedIn, social media, networking, etc. Whenever you want to be connected.